Hey, Daryl here again. I'm on Upper Hutt, so I'm wearing my Upper Hutt shirt. You might notice that this street has a lot of orange road cones and fences in it. If I turn around here, you'll be able to see some more in the background. And that's because this street is getting fibre installed to it, like every street in every town in New Zealand. So the project's more than halfway done, and it's in its second phase where they added more cities into the system. So I'll just show you some of this. As you can see, they've trenched all the way down the side of the road here and put in the ducting for the fibres that go to every individual house. So when they install fibre, they use a combination of horizontal drilling machines and signs. They put up a lot of signs and road cones, they dig some trenches, they have to put in some trenches where the equipment connects, and the cabinet there, that's just around here, with all of the pretty pictures on it, they put these sorts of pictures, and these are quite often where the fibres or DSL comes to. This might be an old, looks old, this one, it's got old writing on it. See, it's got a bit of graffiti, but those stickers and stuff are really old. So this is probably VDSL and ADSL cabinet and other phone equipment cabinet. It's got it's got Chorus written on there. Chorus is the company that in most towns and cities in New Zealand owns the fibres and twisted pairs that come to the house. So here up in the poles, you can see that there's a big fat cable TV cable, which is nothing to do with this. And then the traditional three-phase power up the top and home power down the bottom, high voltage three-phase and lower standard home voltage power. Yeah, but there we go, that's a bit of infrastructure in the street. I better get going, looks like it's gonna rain. So I hope you enjoyed the video. That's just a little introduction about how you can quickly install fibre in a neighbourhood. And we're doing this to, I think, more than 85% of the houses in New Zealand. So it's a pretty huge project, costing a few billion dollars, but it's not that expensive really. And it's really awesome because now almost everybody can have gigabit internet at home.